Hi everybody, it's me, Divina de Campo, from Season 1, UK's Drag Race. Here are a few things I wish I'd known after I'd left the competition. Losing is the new winning.
Divina de Campo. The Vivian. Congratulations, you are the top two queens of the season.
It was so surreal when RuPaul announced that I was in the top two. No, it wasn't. That's bullshit. I knew I was going to be there. F*** them bitches. The final time we were performing, I got to do all of those crazy tricks and flips and spinning around with all those beautiful boys. How often do you get to do that? What a brilliant experience for me. And then for it to be captured on TV as well. Gorgeous. The thing that was going through my mind was, as I was doing the splits, I was like, I don't know what these words are. Rhubarb, 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 rhubarb. The one thing that I wish I could have said to myself, like, back then was, it's just drag. Like, this isn't quantum physics. It's not life or death. So just chill out. Like, it really doesn't matter. Up until probably like episode 6, I was just a bag of anxiety and nerves and existential dread. For me, getting to chat to Katya, it was exactly what I needed right at that moment. There's a connection there. We're both a bit crazy.
So what would you tell me right here, right now, in order to win?
You're just in your one-woman show. There's nobody else. Even Ru, that's your assistant.
Yeah.
Michelle, she's an intern. You gotta just put everybody down and you're just on this gilded pedestal.
So it wasn't until right at the end where I was like, oh, wait a minute. I've done okay. Why am I so stressed?
The UK's first drag race superstar is the Vivian.
I think the only way that I've turned not winning into a success for myself is by remembering that there's no pressure then. The winner is like you have an expectation to be the best of the best, the most polished, the most perfect, the best vocals. You have to be like saintly on social media. No, I don't need to do that. I didn't win. So I can quite happily go on Twitter and tell people to f*** off. The girl band challenge was some really good fun. I've spent a lot of time working with Bagger and Blue. So for me, that was like, okay, I know how this works. Let's put that coat on, off we go. Let's make this happen. Performing at DragCon in London was amazing. Such a great experience because the whole place just sort of stopped and turned to look at the stage when the Frock Destroyers came on. So that was great. That was a really great experience.
Electra, you danced your way into our hearts. Now, go out and shock the world. Sashay away.
I can't thank you enough for all you've given me. And I can't wait for whatever's coming next. Thank you.
What I want to say to you is just enjoy it. Go out, say yes to everything, do everything that you can, do the stuff that you want to do, and enjoy it. Just have fun. And also, you know, get the money, girl. Get it all. Get all the money. Or marry a rich man. Hooray! There's something really special about being a Drag Race cast member, especially being from the first series, you know, of a franchise. There's something really special about that because you're part of the OG. And that's what you girls are, part of the OGs now. Welcome to the family. And that's kind of what it is as well. It's a family. Because nobody else has had that same experience and it is crazy. It's time for you to sashay your way into our hearts. Because girl, the real race starts now. Rub, rub! I think if I'd written a lipstick message, I probably would have said, I'll see you in therapy. God knows I need it.